One of the youngest and most picturesque volcanoes in all of Russia is the distinguishable gray peak known as Karymsky. In the last 50 years, this volcano has been erupting 59.2% of the time, with this period involving 8 distinct eruptions, each of which regularly emitted ash plumes to a height generally 1 to 5 kilometers above its peak. One of these eruptions lasted a whopping 20 years in length, which began after magma at depth that was jointly shared by two volcanoes caused Karymsky to erupt, followed by Academia Nock 12 hours later, marking the latter volcano's first eruption in 1,000 years, with this occurring in 1996. Ever since then, Karymsky has seemingly been rejuvenated, never going more than 16 months without another eruption occurring. One reason for the stark beauty of this magnificent stratovolcano is that not only are all of its features quite easy to spot in the summit symmetrical edifice it contains, but also due to the fact that the entire modern stratovolcano sits within a 115-meter or 377-foot deep caldera. This caldera forms a large barrier, allowing for large volumes of viscous andesite and dacite lava to pool at depths of more than 500 feet in some areas. The modern cone of Karymsky, and thus the entire volcano, could be said to only be 6,100 years old, as that represents its oldest eruption. However, that metric represents a potential problem. You see, different sources cite that there are either one or three stratovolcanoes present along a 13-kilometer-long fault line. Thus, some sources claim that the long-extinct Devor volcano, Karymsky, and Academia Nock are each distinct volcanoes, while others suggest that they are all parts of the same single volcano. This becomes all the more confusing when you learn that the active magma chamber which supplies the modern Karymsky cone is not located directly underneath it, but rather 2 kilometers to the south. For this video, we are assuming that these represent three separate volcanoes, with Devor erupting between 190 and 150,000 years ago, Academia Nock erupting between 70,000 years ago in 1996, and Karymsky erupting between 6600 BCE and 2022. Before Karymsky existed, there was the large Devor stratovolcano which covered the northern swath of the modern caldera, while also containing a series of flank cinder cones along the aforementioned fault line. Devor collapsed into a caldera during a truly climactic eruption 177,000 years ago, forming its summit caldera in an eruption which ejected 49.82 cubic kilometers of tephra. After large volumes of dacite magma intrude into the existing andesite magma chamber in 6600 BCE, it caused enormous volumes of molten rock to shoot upwards, triggering a powerful ultra-Plinian eruption and the birth of the Karymsky volcano. This eruption caused the volcano's magma chamber to partially drain, causing the rock overlying it to collapse downwards and fill the empty space, resulting in the formation of a 5 kilometer wide and 5.6 kilometer long caldera. This collapse caused the southern half of Devor to collapse along with its southern flank fence. Pyroclastic flows generated from this eruption likely reached up to 16 kilometers distant, and regions close to the eruption site were filled by as much as 50 feet thick of ash and pyroclastic flow deposits. In the aftermath of this VEI-6 eruption, the underlying magma chamber shifted position and moved slightly to the south, which would not erupt for another 2,500 years. When the modern cone began growing in 4100 BCE, large, slow-moving dacite lava flows advanced down the slopes of the caldera, largely towards the south, while intermittent volcanic explosions occurred relating to the temporary plugging and clearing of the volcano's magma conduit. Numerous similar eruptions occurred over the next 3300 years, building a 400-meter-high stratovolcano with a central vent. Karymsky then did not erupt for a 2,100-year-long time span between 800 BCE and 1500 CE. When its most recent eruptive phase began, the volcano now only erupted high silica andesites. Since then, the distinguishing gray color of this volcano that is not covered with any green vegetation represents areas this lava has coated, representing the vast majority of the volcano's surface. While Karymsky has produced eruption plumes that rose more than 30,000 feet into the atmosphere, such large explosions have in recent times been uncommon. Some Strombolian eruptions have also occurred, but these are also uncommon, with eruptions in recent years primarily being Volcanian and only small to moderate in size. Thanks for watching. I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.